The developing world is awash in substandard, degraded or falsified medications, which can either directly harm users or deprive them of needed treatment. And with internet sales of medications on the rise, people everywhere are increasingly at risk. So a team of researchers has developed a simple, inexpensive, paper-based device to screen suspicious medications. Medications can be compromised in many different ways. For example, they may be bulked up with fillers, or they can degrade because they are stored improperly. Identifying poor quality medications is challenging, as inspectors may not know in advance what chemical adulterants or degradation products they need to look for. Plus, bad quality medications may contain at least some of the active ingredient. So, simply detecting the presence of the real medication isn't enough to rule out issues. The researchers developed a card to detect falsified or degraded antibiotics. To screen for a variety of potential quality issues, the researchers included 12 lanes separated by waxed barriers on the paper device. Each lane contained a different set of reagents to detect materials or functional groups found in active pharmaceutical ingredients, degradation products, or common fillers. To run a sample, the researchers crushed a pill and rubbed the resulting powder across all 12 lanes and then dipped the bottom of the paper card in water for 3 minutes. The water wicks up the lanes, bringing reagents into contact with the powder. Colors are formed when the reagent interact with the pharmaceutical, filler or degradation product. The researchers then compare the color pattern from the sample with the color patterns obtained from high quality pharmaceutical products. The comparison can be done by eye or with an image analysis program on a smartphone. The researchers explained their device in the ACS press meet.
Thank you. I guess maybe I'd like to start by introducing people to the problem that we're trying to solve. And really, this is our central problem. These are medications that are very effective against malaria. And so they're really important from a health standpoint in large parts of the developing world. One of these packets of medicine is a falsified product. It doesn't contain the active ingredients, it's just starch. And so the problem is that this kind of medicine is really difficult to detect in the low resource settings where it tends to appear. And that's the problem that we're trying to solve. And really this touches on issues of basic fairness and justice. If people are paying for medicine, they deserve to get medicine.
So this issue affects people from every level. So it affects the patients that are supposed to be prescribing these medications because it starts to make them question their confidence in the medical system. And then it affects the buyers that buy it directly from the manufacturers because they start to question the quality of the investment that they're making into this pharmaceutical. The solution that we've developed is a paper analytical device. It's a simple test card about the size of an index card that Maria can display here.
So I brought some. This is a little foil pack that we have, and we can put about 20 of these cards in the pack. And a single card can be used to test many different kinds of medications. So this card is designed to test antibiotics and tuberculosis medications, but it also works for some other drugs. So for example, for some diabetes medications and heart medications. And that kind of drug for chronic conditions is becoming a lot more important in the developing world. And so the test cards are inexpensive and they're very easy to use. So it gives people who have a question about a medicine something that they can use to do a quick screening test to determine if the medicine is falsified or not.
And then based off of these screening tests, we can follow it up using high-performance liquid chromatography to Notre Dame. But asking Notre Dame to take on the task of analyzing every pharmaceutical that's collected is rather hefty. And so Notre Dame has partnered with other institutions around the nation to assist in this analysis, which is where my university, Hamline, came in. We analyzed ciprofloxacin. And while we have these samples, we're able to look for different components that affect the quality of medicine. So we did X-ray fluorescence on the tablets, which is a non-destructive technique that can detect the inorganic components that are also present in the tablets, possibly as a colorant and things of that. Using these different techniques and the different devices in the DPAL program, we're able to potentially look at trends that we see with manufacturers. So if a manufacturer is consistently having quality issues, we're able to report that to the respective regulatory agency in the country, and then also hopefully do a faster analysis so that these pharmaceuticals aren't reaching as many patients and harming them.